sweating too. It's fucking hot.
It's fucking super sweaty in here.
Once I start talking,
I'm schwitzing and trying to play it off like
this. We're with Cherub. How are you guys doing today?
What's up, man?
Good. How are you?
How are you?
Pretty good. So my first question is, what would you say your first major accomplishment?
I think making a living off of touring would probably be the first thing.
I mean, definitely when I no longer had to call my parents when we would get stuck somewhere, you know, without gas, couldn't get home from tour or something like that, when we were cool, we'll never have to do this again. That was a really awesome moment. I mean, the other one that I always remember, the first tour we went on was in Mexico.
Really?
I mean, that was tight too,
It was the first time we called it a pinch yourself moment, where we were standing on a balcony in Puerto Vallarta looking at the Pacific Ocean, and we were just damn, this is tight. We're here to play music.
So the first one I pretty much made by myself in a room with no idea of how it would be worked up live or anything. So I think a lot of the evolution of the sound has come from us playing shows live, seeing what people react to in person, and feeling the energy from the crowds. Okay, so we both grew up, he grew up in North Carolina, I grew up in Nebraska, but we've been in Nashville for the past 10 years. And we've seen a lot of changes in Nashville. And I think what we always come back to is Nashville's, where they set the bar for being a musician is so high that if you want to, it's inspiring first of all, but if you want to actually do it, you got to at least be this good. You know, there's no room for shitty.
There's no
music.
Just talking the talk there. You have to be able to actually
So that's been pretty cool.
You know, we're base half of our business on the internet and stuff like that. So technology's all over the place. But I think the coolest thing that ends up being really inspirational for us is the immediate access to sounds now. So if you if you're dreaming up a sound, Jordan can go in the computer in a couple clicks, pull up this really crazy guitar tone. You know, that instead you would normally have to spend hours and hours figuring this thing out and miking it up, and then he can, instead of wasting time with that, be immediately inspired and take it and apply it musically, you know. And that's just that's a cool thing that when we're in the studio really helps us get creative.
And also it allows there to be such a thing as a one-man band type scenario, because we don't have a drummer on stage, we don't have, you know, and those things are because of technology though.
We're two-man, one-man band.
No, we're a one-man band because you're my other half.
And we did get valuable networking out of that. I don't want to knock on college, but
it's where we met.
Met and got things going. But I will say, this is a tacky saying, but it's the truest saying to me, is that if you believe in yourself and you follow your heart and you are passionate about something, you actually go and do it. You don't need to worry about what anybody else is saying, because I think everything else follows from that.
It's true.
Just don't worry about anything else. Just fucking do it. Be yourself. I'm going hard with this thing because it's true. Just be yourself.
No, but you go to the gym every day. You're stoked on that.
Pretty healthy, to kind of neutralize my nightlife. I've been I've been going to the gym.
I keep a steady regimen of blunts going on.
Jason smokes a lot of weed.
I keep on a nice even keel that way. I always change my shoes before I go on stage.
I'll probably change a shirt before I go on stage. I drink a lot of
help
water.
Get in the right mindset.
I don't drink any liquor or any caffeine before the shows. People always think
that's been not really a ritual, but just a
rule to follow.
We want to make sure people get
an unwritten rule. We always go on stage sober. You know, it's out of respect to each other and out of respect to the crowd, and just also because it sucks when you're fumbling around and you feel like you can't control your own hands, like you're playing in mittens on. It's playing drunk.
It would ruin my drum if I was focusing so much.
Yeah.
This is hard.
I give up.
I was 9. At a very young age, I knew that this is what I wanted to do, and I spent my time on nothing else.
Yeah, I was a little older than that, but
in somewhere in high school.
And when did you guys meet? At what age?
We were 18? In college, yeah. Like known in freshman year of college. It's kind of crazy, right?
Yeah, dude, it is.
Come a long way.
Yeah, we still like each other.
Yeah.
So that's important.
Yeah. Not seeing each other yet.
No. I don't like whisper angry things at them during sets. I know bands like they'll be playing like, fuck you. Like constantly, just the only thing we know how to do is be creative and make music
and or play music.
And yeah, so it's like we're gonna constantly be doing that, and what people can expect is us just putting out what we feel's our heart.
Mm-hmm. I know that on this last record, we took 2 years putting it together, and that was a long time. And as awesome as it was, and as much as we love the whole process, it was a long time, you know. So we're pretty excited to start putting music out.
There's too many bands
on a more regular basis. You know?
There's too many bands to not be putting out music. It's just such a large market of music. You gotta be consistent with it.
Hey, thanks for your time.
Thank you guys.
Thank you.
Champagne and cocaine, how could you get me through?